Hey guys, and welcome back to Mad About Skin. In today's video, I'm sharing with you the products I purchase most often. These are the products that I just can't stop buying time and time again, and are my true loves when it comes to skincare. I've got a little something for every step in the routine here, from some amazing cleansers through to some gorgeous, gorgeous moisturizers, and some fantastic serums in between. So if you want to find out those products that I do buy time and time again, and you might want to think of for your own skincare routine, keep on watching. Now this video, I was inspired to film when I was watching a very similar video from James Welsh. I love, love, love James's channel, and I'm so inspired by a lot of the content he creates, which is really unique, different, and honestly, just so fun to watch. So I saw it and thought, yes, I would love, love, love to film a version of this for my channel, because I think often as, you know, content creators here on YouTube, we get accused of mixing things up a little bit too much, you know, grabbing for the latest trend or the latest thing. It's just not realistic for people to continually buy new products and recycle them. So I thought now would be a great time to share with you that actually I do have those products that stay in my routine day in, day out and never change, and these are the ones that I want to mention today. I streamed it down because I could have included a whole lot, but I thought I'd keep it to a very concise collection. But I have left a link to James's video below if you do want to check it out. Below in the description box are also links to any of the products mentioned today if you do want more information. But let's cut the waffle, let's jump straight on into it. I think we should start with cleansers. I love, love, love a good cleanser, and I think it can do so much to just kickstart your routine in the right way. My go-to is this. This is the Jelly Joker Cleanser by Geek & Gorgeous. I know, I've probably mentioned this quite a lot on the channel, and you're probably all bored of me referencing it, but it is so nice for the price point. It's cruelty-free, as are all of the recommendations I make today. It's luxurious, it's bouncy, it feels like that jelly-like consistency really comes through, and I think it kind of gives you a spa-like bougie feel for like £10 here in the UK. And honestly, a tube of this probably lasts me 2 or 3 months. So I don't buy it as often as normally I should for a product I love this much, because honestly, a little goes such a long way. Doesn't strip, doesn't dry, and I feel it would work for most skin types. While we're kind of fangirling about Geek & Gorgeous, I'm going to just quickly mention this, because you're all going to ream me to Phil for constantly banging on about this product. But this is the liquid hydration, best toner out there. And they're also bringing it out in the next month in a spray. So if you like a mist, you can get this in that mist form, which honestly, I'll be the first in the queue to buy. Packed full of amino acids and panthenol to calm, soothe and hydrate. Honestly, all you need. I could fangirl a lot about Geek & Gorgeous, but I don't want it to just dominate this video. So I'll actually leave a link up there to a video I did on Geek & Gorgeous if you want to learn a little bit more about the brand. Now, before we move on from cleansers, I do just want to give a shout out to two other products. First is this. This is CN and their micellar water. Now, this isn't a product I talk about too much on the channel because it's not available internationally. It's a European brand, which is available at Lidl, which is like a superstore here in the UK and in Europe. But this is 98 pence. For all this product, and honestly, it is the perfect cruelty-free dupe for the Bioderma micellar water. If you're spending your hard-earned euros and pounds on the original Bioderma, you're wasting your money, because honestly, this is the perfect, perfect dupe. You can't tell the difference, and this one's cruelty-free, so it's just got an added benefit. Your wallet will love you, your skin will love you, and this is just great. I use it after the gym, wipe off all that sweat and that exercise, you know, everything bad that's happened to the skin whilst I've been exercising, gets it off in one, and it's just a really, really nice product. No body cleanser routine or mention would be complete without this. This is the Aesop Arose by Any Other Name body wash, which I reference so often on the channel. It's so bougie, it's so expensive, and I'm desperately seeking a dupe, but I just haven't found it yet. It smells so, so good. It's uplifting, and the scent alone is why I buy this, because it transforms your bathroom into like this luxury Turkish spa with the really exotic scent of the rose in here. So good. I'm looking for a dupe. I tried the Lush Rose Jam body wash, and that is quite close. It's not quite as nice as this in my view, but it's very, very close and so much more affordable. So if you can't push to Aesop prices, then obviously that Lush one would be a really great dupe that you could reach for, but honestly, I just don't think there's any comparison when it comes to this product. Now, let's move on to serums. I guess we've cleansed our skin, we're fresh, we're glowing to the gods, and we're ready to put on some serums to enhance our skin. The Azaclear A15 Serum by Face Theory, honestly, one of my favourites. I love, love, love this, and I actually switched from this to a prescription strength, higher strength azelaic acid and actually didn't get the same results. This is because this one's got aloe vera, green tea as an antioxidant, but also packed full of oat, which calms and soothes. Azelaic acid is like my ride or die absolute favorite ingredient when it comes to skincare, and I captured all the reasons why I love it in a video, so I'll link that up there. But honestly, if you were suffering with acne, breakouts, hyperpigmentation, redness, sensitivity, azelaic acid is your best friend. And this is probably the strongest azelaic acid you can get without a prescription. In the UK, the 15% is available. In the US, it's a 10% due to regulations in that specific territory. But wherever in the world you are, whether you choose the 10 or the 15%, you'll get such great results because it's those added ingredients to just dial up the total effects of the product. While I'm calling it out, I'm going to give a shout out to this. This is the Blush by Face Theory. Now, I'm not somebody that wears a lot of makeup. I'll do a bit of concealer to hide the odd zit and blemish, but this is a really great blush. Now, I did a full review of Face Theory and their new makeup and stuff. I didn't include the blushes because I thought they'd be too difficult to swatch. This I love. It gives a really light flush to the skin, and also I kind of feel it offsets some of my residual hyperpigmentation. I'm really conscious about my hyperpigmentation, and it's super light now thanks to some of the products I've used, but it's still there in the right light. And so I just put a tiny amount on this. Gives a natural flush to the skin, helps disguise some of that hyperpigmentation without having to wear a full face of makeup. And honestly, I really, really like it. It is so pigmented. So if you do decide to buy this, and this is in the 2, they do 4 colours for each skin type. This is the 2, which is the mid shade. If you do go for it, a little goes such a long way. You have been warned. Now, when it comes to Deciem, you guys know I'm a fan of so many of their products, from The Ordinary, Hyalamide and Neod, but I didn't want to just clutter this video with like a total fangirl moment for Deciem. So I've picked out my favourites. The Repigment by Neod is my favourite serum possibly of all time. Talked about my hyperpigmentation a minute ago, and the thing that's made the biggest difference to this and my confidence has been the Repigment. 15 different pathways for eliminating and tackling hyperpigmentation, and honestly, after 2 bottles of this, I noticed a 60% reduction in my overall pigmentation issues, and my confidence just returned. Total splurge worthy product. I know it's expensive, and a lot of people do say you don't get a lot, which you don't, but because you're just targeting on the specific areas, I think a little does really go a long way. 2 bottles of this in, 60% reduction in my hyperpigmentation. Honestly, this is probably the one product I never think twice about before repurchasing. Whatever the price, I just know it's done so much for my confidence, the way I feel about my skin. I love it so much. Before we move on to Hyalamide, I want to give a quick shout out to this product. This is the Neod set, where you get in here the Survival 30, and you also get a free product, which is the Saccharide Mist. I love the mist, antioxidant, hydrating, all the good stuff. But I always buy the Neod Survival 30, which is a powerful antioxidant with an SPF of 30 built in as well. This is the set. I think it's exclusive to Selfridges here in the UK. But if you are going to buy, if you're in the UK and you can get your hands on this, if you are going to buy the Survival, pick up this set because you get the mist thrown in for free. So it's like a £15 saving, and who doesn't love a free product from Neod? So I did just want to call this out, but just alone, even if you're not in the UK and can't get the set, the Survival 30 is definitely worth it. Just for that product alone, definitely worth the price. I think I'm on my 10th bottle now. Maybe even a little bit more. I don't keep track of it, but definitely I bought it multiple times. I said I'd come to Hyalamide, which is another brand in the Deciem family. And very quickly, I'm going to call out the Sub-Q Skin. I covered this because it was my favourite serum from last year. Love the product so much. It's my go-to peptide. People often say, which is better, the Sub-Q Skin by Hyalamide or the Copper Amino Isolate Serum by Neod? I say they're both fantastic. But in terms of all-round performance, I think Hyalamide just edge it, which is why I think I buy it time and time again. Sub-Q Skin hydrates the skin, it helps with hyperpigmentation, and it produces collagen, boosts the collagen levels in the skin to just give you that gorgeous anti-aging overhaul. I love it, and I'm probably on, well, I bought 4 bottles of it when they had their sale last November, and I think I probably bought 3 or 4 since. So yeah, definitely a product that I bought time and time again, and I'd say one bottle lasts about a month, because it is a product you want to apply quite liberally to get the benefit, so you'll just call that out. Now, one product my wallet was praying I really, really didn't like, but unfortunately I absolutely loved, was this. This is the Stratia Liquid Gold. This is now my 4th bottle that I'm on. Stratia isn't a brand that's easily accessible here in the UK. A subscriber kindly sent me so many of their products to start, and that kind of kickstarted my obsession. And you can import it from the US, which is what I've done when I bought subsequent bottles of this. However, you do have to pay some charges in terms of shipping and some handling fees, so I'll call that out. But if you're in North America, Stratia honestly is a brand to die for. So many of their products great, and this liquid gold, Just everything. If I have a day where my skin feels a little bit sensitive, maybe I've used a strong exfoliator and my skin feels a little bit red, just one application of this sorts it all out. It protects the barrier, it's packed full of ceramides, just does everything you need to build your skin up and give you a really good skin day the following day. Put this on before you go to bed, and honestly, the next morning, you wake up, your skin is snatched, glowing to the gods, and feeling like it can face whatever the day throws at you. I love this product. I really, really wish I didn't in terms of the price because it is a little bit more expensive here in the UK. But honestly, if you can get your hands on it, your skin will love you. Now, I've got one more product for the face before I come on to some body recommendations. And I had to sit and think long and hard about which is the sunscreen that I've used and purchased the most. And in truth, it's this. This is the Skinny's Sun Gel. Now, it was between this and the Make Prem UV Defense Me Fluid. But the only reason I plumped for Skinny's is because they've reformulated the Make Prem. I actually love the product even more, but I haven't bought the new formulation that often because it's only recently been launched, which is why Skinny's just pipped me to it. This, such a great product. Packed full of shea butter, which is hydrating and nourishing, and this is the product I always take with me on the beach. Yes, it's not the cheapest product out there. Here in the UK, much cheaper than it is in some other locations. I know over in New Zealand, where they're based, it is a lot cheaper, again, because you don't have to factor in the shipping. But if you can get your hands on this, it is such a great sunscreen. Hydrates to the gods, give you that gorgeous shine to the skin without it feeling overly like greasy or oily. Just gives a really nice finish if you like a little dewiness to the finish to the complexion. And such great product. They do a reef safe version. They also do a higher SPF 50, which is the only reason I don't go for it, is because I think day to day here in the UK, SPF 30 is more than enough for my skin. The SPF 50 is a little bit thicker, but still just melts like butter onto the skin. Total holy grail, and one I can definitely recommend. Now, I promise that's enough love for the face. I could mention so many other products, such as the Azure Line Solution by The Ordinary, which I love, favorite anti-aging peptide, but I wanted to keep it to a little bit more of a tight and concise collection. And these are the ones I think I've purchased in the highest volume over the past 2 years. Then finally, for the body, I'm calling out this. This is the Sucra Fresh Body Scrub by Face Theory. This is like my fourth or fifth bottle. I literally have just dipped my finger in just because I love the scent. And this is gorgeous. A blend of 5 oils and sugars, which went on the body. Okay, we're all a bit, you know, skeptical of scrubs for the face. And I usually say probably not the best way to exfoliate. But for the body, for the feet, for the elbows, for the knees, such a great way. This, you get about 5 applications, maybe 6 applications in this, and it goes so, so well with the bathroom. The whole bathroom smells like a tropical holiday that we all wish we can go on, but we can't. Pina coladas, in a product, I love this. It's got 5 oils in here, so it hydrates the body at the same time as exfoliating, and that sugar just dissolves and melts and everything. It's not one of those products when you wash it off in the bath, sometimes the products can leave the bath feeling a little scuzzy, a little bit with that film. You don't get this with this. It actually just transforms your bath into like that gorgeous spa, that holiday we all need in our lives. This, such a great product. It comes with a little applicator tool, like a little wooden applicator tool, which I always lose. I won't worry too much about that. It does, it's nice if you want to do an element of massage when you're applying it, but I lose it and can never be bothered with that. So I just apply it with my hands, and such a great find. So there you have it, guys. These are my true loves in skincare. Obviously, this collection changes day in, day out, and there's so many that I should have included and missed. Oh, The Ordinary Ascorbyl Tetra Isopalmitate Vitamin C Derivative. Love that. Just alone now, I can think of so many others I should include, but I didn't want it to run to, you know, too long a video, so we'll call it at this point. But share with me your one true skincare love. Leave me a comment below, and while you're down there, if you have a chance to hit that like button, it'd be much appreciated. Wherever you are in the world, or whatever your one true love, sending you so, so much love from here in the UK. Take care. Bye.